Subhanallah wa bihamdihi subhanallahil azim. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi subhanallahil azim. Subhanallah wa bihamdihi.
Alhamdulillah, praise be to Allah. We should be very grateful to Allah. So grateful that in such hard circumstances, with problems and worries and difficulties, that the condition of our heart or hearts is not correct. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with His grace and blessings and His mercy, gives big, big rewards of the akhirah, the hereafter, to an individual. And tonight, the night what Allah ta'ala has given to us, I cannot be grateful enough for the whole of my life what Allah ta'ala has given to us. This is a great night, my friends. It's a great ni'mah that Allah ta'ala has given to us. Because we don't know if in our lives we will get a night like this again or not. It is a very beautiful month, months you can say, that are passing very speedily. Rajab is going and Shaban is coming. So these two, you can say we're at the transition point of these 2 months. Today we'll be sitting. So today is the 30th of Rajab, which is passing, and it passes after Maghrib, from an Islamic point of view. And alhamdulillah, congratulations to you that today is the night of Shaban, the first of Shaban, which is starting. So these two points, one is past and one is coming. And for Rajab, Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, also for Shaban, with his blessed statement, and he did dua, he made a prayer. And in this dua, the whole ummah is included, alhamdulillah, that, oh my Mawla, my Lord, Rajab, the month of Rajab and Shaban, put blessings into these months. So, great barakat, blessings, Allah Ta'ala has kept hidden for us, and alhamdulillah, I speak about myself, that all 30 days we wasted, and in reality, the barakat of this month, we didn't attain anything in reality. If we look at ibadah, worship, if we start saying that we've done ibadah and worship, fair enough, maybe we did, but there's no barakah, no blessing, because the genuine thing behind the ibadah is the barakah. Remember this, don't measure and weigh that, oh, I have attained the blessings of this month. In reality, barakah is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Blessings are from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that individual who is deserved and waits and wants the rahmas of Allah, that Allah is ghafoorur raheem. Allah is ghafoorur raheem, that I am a Rabb, and with the ummah, with the humanity, with the people, the human beings, Allah Ta'ala says, I have two links that connect my rahmah to the people, ghafuriyat and rahmat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if somebody becomes deserved of these two things, then he's attained all of the barakat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If someone deserves these two things or attains. So in Rajab, did we attain this? That definitely yes, we are deserved of this now, and we're hopeful that Allah will give us these two things, and Allah Ta'ala has accepted us to give us these two things that Allah Ta'ala gives to His servants, Ghafoor and Rahim. So then consider that alhamdulillah, we have attained the barakat of this month. Now Ghafuriyat, Allah Ta'ala, His Ghaffar, and this is linked to Maghfirah, forgiveness. So this is the first sift, the first attribute, quality that Allah Ta'ala has mentioned, that a person should become such that individual, Allah Ta'ala said that he should be so deserved of this quality of mine, that I forgive that individual. I forgive that individual. And in my register, this should be the scenario that I've forgiven this individual. So my brothers, let's think here now, that have we attained this barakah in Rajab? Have we? I remember a verse, and it is linked to this, and the verse has a link and a connection. Inna alladhina amanu, Allah Ta'ala says in the Quran that you've got iman, you're a believer, and you have iman. Then Allah Ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ هَاجِرُوا وَجَهَدُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أُولَٰئِكَ. Allah says, يَرْجُونَ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. Say, Subhanallah. Subhanallah. It's a beautiful verse that's come to my mind, and it's a very straightforward translation of this. That Allah Ta'ala says that they are mu'mins, you are mu'mins, there's no doubt you have iman. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. But my rahmah, who is deserved of my rahmah? Allah says that أُولَٰئِكَ يَرْجُونَ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ. Have you thought of this? You are people of iman, you are Muslimin. So what will you do that will cause you to deserve my rahmah? What amal are they that we should be doing? Now Rajab has passed. So how many people have passed away, and they have passed away before Ramadan? May Allah Ta'ala not allow this, that just like Rajab we have wasted, and we waste this month. We earn sins, we lie, we do haram, we deceive. Imagine. So my brothers, this is not the reason of life, making your parents, reading Quran, praying Salah. Allah Ta'ala says, my angels do this so many times over. Something I've created within you that is not within any malaika or angel. And that on that basis, I weigh your deeds. And what is that basis? That within you, Allah Ta'ala says, that I've put a chip, I've inserted a chip inside you. No angel has this. Jibreel doesn't have this. Mikael doesn't have this. And upon this criterion basis, I gave you the rank of Ashraf al-Makhlukat and the levels of thereafter, that I gave you the strength to commit sin, and your nafs will make you commit sin. And you, due to my fear, you have to save yourself in life with purity. You have to pass your life. Yes, great holy Allah, great pious predecessors before us, they have told us, you don't need to do mujahada, you can pray Salah 5 times a day and fast and give zakat and go on hajj. And you don't need to do any extra voluntary ibadah, nafl, long hisab, long sheets of deeds. But one thing, don't commit the sins. Allah Ta'ala says, so then you won't go with a small hisab, rather you will depart from this world as a kutub, as awliya Allah, wali Allah. So on what basis? But the life that we live, we do haram, we commit haram deeds, we consume haram, and we live like thieves, and we deceive and commit fraud. Allah Ta'ala says, this is the opposite. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, Allah Ta'ala says that those people of iman and who make effort. Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ يَرْجُونَ رَحْمَةَ اللَّهِ. Allah Ta'ala says that those people, they are deserved of Allah Ta'ala's rahmah, mercy. Which people? Which people? They will earn Allah's ghafoor and rahmah. Allah's forgiveness and rahmah. By talking, by debating, will we get this? Or by showing off to people? Is this what we'll earn? No, the point is what Allah Ta'ala has described. It's not my choice that these certain deeds will get me rewards. Deen is Allah's, Allah will account. We are Allah's servants. So how can we make our own deen up ourselves? Oh, no, we won't be like this, we'll be like this. No, not this, this is the scale. Allah Ta'ala says, no, what I'm telling you, that is what will occur. So what is Allah Ta'ala saying? If today we understand this message, then the amal will start from today, will it? Say it loudly, inshallah. Inshallah. That's then we can say that we have rightfully fulfilled what we have learned. What we need to do is that in these months, rather until Ramadan, may Allah Ta'ala forgive us. And we are included in the list of those people Allah Ta'ala says, I've forgiven you. That's what Allah Ta'ala is saying, Wallahu Ghafoor Rahim. And secondly, Allah says, that person who I forgive, Allah says, then on that person, not just rahmah, Allah Ta'ala says, I will rain down the mercies on those people. Rain down. So how can then his requirements not be fulfilled? Allah says, I'm Rahim. The rahmah upon rahmah will come to the person, his home, children, offspring, outside, inside, mal, wealth, ibadat, Quran, sadaqat, charity, tahajjud, nawafil, voluntary actions. Then the noor comes into that person's life. And this is called rahim, Allah's rahmah, Allah's mercy. Should we get this or not? Should we attain this or not? So if we should, then what should we do? Inna ladina amanu, Allah says, wajahadu. وَهَاجَرُوا وَجَهَدُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. Say Subhanallah, Subhanallah. Look, two things Allah Ta'ala has explained. One is dahir, one is apparent, one is batin, one is hidden. And very beautiful points have been said. I've heard these points from the awliya Allah. So I'm explaining this to you now, discussing and sharing with you. So if we go with the translation of the verse, then totally as the verse is explaining to us, that is what it means. The Allah Ta'ala says that those people who migrate, leave their homes, and they struggle in the path of Allah, and Allah Ta'ala says, for those people, they are deserved of my rahmah. They are deserved of my rahmah, of my mercy. So this is the different point. This is a small struggle. Allah Ta'ala's Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that the genuine struggle is against what? What is the bigger battle? It's the battle against the nafs, say Subhanallah. Subhanallah. It's the fight against the desires. So here, وَجَهَدُوا وَهَاجِرُوا وَجَهَدُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, for the sake of Allah. Allah Ta'ala says that physically we people struggle, extra, that's fine, that's dahiri, that's physical. But these struggles will not continue until Qiyamah. That was at the time of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Those struggles and quarrels will not come now, but the Quran will continue till Qiyamah. The Jamaat will be created, which will be deserved of Allah's Maghfirah and Rahmat and Ghafuriyat. So what is that fight and that struggle that Allah Ta'ala is defining here in this verse and then according to the Hadith? Hijrat. Migration. Migration isn't just this, that you go from one house to another house, or from one city to another city, for the sake of Allah, fair enough, you're transferring. But the proper migration is what? This is the migration, that a person leaves the realm and the world of sins. Allahu Akbar, he leaves the world of sins and he reaches where? He reaches to the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanallah. And this is the proper hijrat, migration, that we have left that life where we committed sins, committed fraud, lied, bad actions. We reject this. We migrate from there. Towards where? Subhanallah. We migrate from the sins, transgression, towards Allah Ta'ala's obedience. We leave the home of sins and we come to the home of obedience. And this is what Allah Ta'ala says, wahajaru. And then once we do hijrat, once we migrate, then Allah says, wajahadu. Then we will try our best for the rest of our lives. For the rest of our lives, we will try and make an attempt. We will not let this opportunity run away from us. Doesn't matter how many times shaitan and nafs attack us. Doesn't matter how many difficulties come. What will they all be? They will be tests from Allah to elevate our darajat, our status. And this is what we call mujahada. Striving. The tests that come and overcoming those tests. We won't slip. We won't slip in any way. So when we come to this point, that we have to do hijrat. We have to reject the sins totally. That we have to, in this month of Rajab, the Rajab that has come to us, if we did this in Rajab, we would got the Barakat. Now Shaban has started, and Ramadan is very close. We're waiting for the 15th night of Shaban, then we'll try hard for forgiveness. It's a big night, we'll strive, and then we'll think that fast is the best. We'll say, don't ask anything else, I've done everything on the 15th night of Shaban. We'll fast the next day, and we'll pray Salah, Fajr time, and lots of noise will be. But we don't know, look at the color of Islam at that during this month. It's not just for that one night, it's amazing. It's shocking. Allah Ta'ala has given us every night like this. Every night is an opportunity to attain the rewards, multitudes of rewards. There's no difference in this point, as I've told you this before. So, this point now, don't wait for this. Rather, after today, we should start from today, not the 15th night of the month. If we want to pass this month correctly, so that we can deserve and be the rightfully due rewards, so we have now Shaban, then this time, this month will continue till Ramadan. Don't worry about Quran, etc., and extra deeds and voluntary deeds, but we should be worried about the fact that we should not be committing any sins or disobeying Allah. Not one inch should we go near compare to those actions where Allah Ta'ala said, stop this, how did I do this? Don't use the tongue wrongly, don't use the eyes wrongly, don't use your ears wrongly, don't use the eyes wrongfully. From morning until night and throughout the night, we should say to each other, we should say to ourselves and promise that I will not commit the sins. And then we can say that this person, وَهَاجَرُوا وَجَهَدُوا فِي سِبِيلَ اللَّهِ, he has implemented the meaning of this verse. Then Allah says, أُولَٰئِكَ يَرْجُونَ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ, that Allah Ta'ala says that these people are deserving of my rahmah. وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ, and definitely for these people I'm غَفُورٌ and رَحِيمٌ. When a person does these actions, so my brothers, we need to try this. We need to make effort towards this. We have wasted Rajab. So we should promise that from our tongue, from our hands, from our eyes, from our body, from our fingers or hands or feet, no action should be committed due to which our Rabb, our Lord, becomes displeased with us, and then we waste our days and nights and opportunities to do good. We should do true migration from the sins, and we should fight against our desires, our base desires. So this is, you can say tonight is a valuable night. I'll say Alhamdulillah, a beautiful night that has come upon us. The Noor, and Noor is meeting with Noor. The departure of Rajab, the Noor is meeting with the coming of Shaban and sitting. We do the dhikr of Allah. But dhikr will be accepted from those people who definitely have made niyyah that we are going to become muhajireen, to migrate from the sins. Because Allah Ta'ala said this straight away. Reward will be given to that person who is the muhajir. You understand muhajir? Who migrates. Allah says that we will be written in the list of people who are the muhajireen. Those people who do mujahidah, who do muhajireen, who migrate from the sins, from the wrong. And then today's dhikr will also be successful. And if amongst us, we in our lives, there's haram or wrong actions or sins, we've taken somebody's haq, somebody's right, we've committed excess with somebody, we've done fraud with somebody, deceived somebody, and we are insan, many things happen from sun, then we should make a niyyah that I sit and do the niyyah here, that I would like to make up for the deeds, my misdeeds. And if we waste tonight, then that night's gone. Rajab will not come back. If we do tawbah today, we'll get the barakat of Rajab and of Shaban. Both benefits we can get in this night, if we are sincere. So do we make a true promise of tawbah, repentance? Inshallah, what we've done in the past, we've wasted. We should think today, if I've committed excess against somebody, I've lied, committed fraud, whatever I've done, then I should be honest and say that it doesn't matter if I get lost, whatever happens, Alhamdulillah, I will not commit the same excesses again. And I will change my life for the better. I will improve myself. Somebody's taken interest, somebody's done a wrong action, somebody's done a misdeed. It's right at this time, he should cancel, annul, eliminate those sins. A lot of things will come from Allah. A lot of things will come from Allah. A lot. A lot will come. My friends, we should not hesitate. Shaban is not a minor thing. What's gone is gone. Rajab has gone, and now Shaban is coming. The month of Shaban is coming. And what we can do tonight, we cannot repeat even on the 15th night. I tell you, on the night of the 15th night of Shaban, when we'll come to the peak, that's a different time. Today is what? What is today? What is it? It is Monday. And do you know, on the day of Monday, what did the Prophet ﷺ say with regards to Monday? Rasulullah ﷺ said that on Mondays I keep the fast, it's a blessed day. It's a very unique day. It's the day that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was born. And Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam said on that on Monday, the deeds of a human being are presented to Allah. And that night is also going. So three nights we've got, mashallah. We've mashallah conquered this day with the fadl of Allah. We've got three noors. Where are we stuck? What will the acceptance be based on? Allah Ta'ala says, وَهَاجِرُوا وَجَهَدُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, the person who repents does hijrat from the sins towards the good life. He says, Allah, I migrate from the bad to the good. I want to get out of this trap. I'm stuck, doesn't matter what happens. Doesn't matter, even if tomorrow I was about to sign a contract and there's a big deal to be signed, there's a bit of deception and fraud and playing games and deceiving people, just stop it now, cancel it now, and with the fadl of Allah, you'll get so much, you'll learn so much, and there'll be no loss. May Allah Ta'ala give us all the qadr, the appreciation of these nights and these few breaths we got left in this life. May Allah Ta'ala give us good breaths and good times and good actions. May Allah protect us from all wrong and bad things. And may Allah give us the blessings of Shaban and take us with ease towards Ramadan, and so that we can prepare fully for the great month, that when we reach to Ramadan with the fadl of Allah, just like a person going for swimming, he goes with full preparation, he knows the tariqah of how to swim, with full preparation he jumps into the pool or dives, then he starts to swim in a nice way with enjoyment. So this is the case here, that we need to make a kit, toolkit, that the ocean of nur is about to come, that we need to dive into, jump into, which is Ramadan. It is the ocean of nur, the sea of light. Nothing can compare. So if we start preparation today, then we'll be able to swim tomorrow in the river of nur of Ramadan. And we'll be able to float and swim and take all of the benefits. If we don't prepare today though, then without preparation we're going to Ramadan, then we'll jump into the ocean and we'll drown. We'll drown. We will not be able to float and benefit. May Allah Ta'ala give us total ability to arrive to Ramadan, to reach into Ramadan. May Allah give us the tawfiq now so that we can leave the sins, become light and pure, create good habits, make good routine from now. That in the morning I'll recite this much, I'll do this much dhikr, and the lessons I've been given or prescribed from a sheikh, you have a link and he's given you ma'mulat, daily schedule of dhikr. Become busy in this from today, that I have established my status, I'll wake up for tahajjud. And obviously there's no game now after Isha that you can pray tahajjud. No. Those days have gone now. Now consider we're close to Ramadan. So when do we get up? Yes, so you don't look at, when you don't play games now. When do we pray salah? In the morning time. Go with preparation, life has changed. I'm a muhajir, I've left the sins, I'm going to a new city now. So I'll wake up for tahajjud, after sleeping I'll wake up for tahajjud, then I'll do some dhikr. Then before takbir ula, I will arrive to the masjid. So consider today Ramadan has started. Started. That's it, just consider this. And tarawih will get every day, and mashallah dhikr will continue. And tarawih of the dhikr, may Allah Ta'ala give us health and iman and give us some aql. That's it. So from now we'll make a good environment, that tahajjud start from today, and make a solid niyyah. Nobody sleep in the morning if you want to be a muhajir. Yes, you've understood that the time for mujahid has started. I promise to Allah that no more games anymore. No more games or chances. I'll make my schedule. I'll read Quran this many times. I'll do dhikr this much. I'll do these actions during the day. And on top of that, that sin, the question doesn't arise. Because if I commit the sin, I'll waste all of my deeds. I'll wipe them, wash them away with the sin. So in these days, a person shouldn't even imagine to commit the sin. Think that if I commit the sin, I'll waste all of the effort I've made. This question doesn't arise. And when these opportunities come, then Allah Ta'ala has explained to us in the Quran. Additionally, Allah Ta'ala said, it's not easy for you to just enter into Jannah. Look at the previous qawms and nations before you, the tests that they had. So when we prepare in the right way, in the correct way, then with that strength and vigor, remember, then the test will start to come towards the insan. Nafs-based desires, shaitan will try to influence us. Oh, look, take this opportunity, benefit from this. You'll get benefit of money from this, you can do this. And then you have to suppress all these desires. No, I cannot do this. And that's the preparation we should make. Proper, solid preparation. That this is the ma'mool we need to follow. And I will recite this many juz of Quran. For in the morning I'll pray tahajjud, do this much dhikr. And I will take the company of my sheikh. And I will regularly, whatever the actions I should be doing, wherever the dhikr is taking place, I will arrive there morning and evening to do dhikr. If we want to be honest in our preparation, that I'm not going to play games anymore. I'm going to reduce the dunya and increase the work of the akhirah. Because Shaban, Rajab, Ramadan, these days will not come back again. For the dunya, the days will come back with the fadl of Allah. Obviously, the days of the world don't end. But these days of the akhirah, benefit of akhirah will not come back again. Let's put a value on them now. So what we should do now is shorten and suppress our worldly or home affairs and increase deen, sleep less, and reduce other things that we do, reduce everything, and go more towards the actions that lead us to Allah. Sit down, make a schedule, a list, a program, timetable. I'll get up this time, then I need to go to the masjid this time. After the masjid, I'll pray ishraq, or I'll pray ishraq regularly. After ishraq, then your habits, or if you want to rest, whatever is your schedule, whatever a person does, I have to do my job, my work, whatever I have to do. And that's it. Should we do this, my friends, or not? Inshallah. A true promise? Yes, you're a little bit light today. Yeah. So, for example, I've given you a beautiful schedule. You should be grateful at least a bit. You're sitting like cold. Yes, such a beautiful schedule I've devised and presented to you. Yeah? So I'll make you wake up from now, especially before the blessed month comes. So go and look at a timetable, change the alarm clock time, wake up at the Tahajjud time. Okay? Fine. Let's recite Durood Sharif. Set your alarm clock for Tahajjud. For Tahajjud, even if the eyes don't open, you'll get the thawab. But start the work from now.